information is changing. Some days ago, we used our workstation, and we have the information there, and we don't need to move it outside. And right now, we have new tendencies like bring your own device, or you are storing your information in the cloud, and the systems are very complex, and they have new vulnerabilities. The last point is about disgruntled employees. That is something important. When you give information about your company to your employees, you need to control how they use that information, because if not, in the future they can use that information against you. So it's something important, and all that points open data leak information in the company. So we need we are going to try to minimize that that risk in our systems when the users use the mobile device. And nowadays, of course, there are solutions to solve part of that problems. For example, if we want to share our computer, we can use user profiles, or we can cipher our systems to maintain the confidentiality of the information, and we can use multiple authentication factors to strengthen the security of our system. And that control the access to the information, but once the user has access to that information, we need to control how that user use that information. And we have also solutions like Microsoft Information Right Management Service or Adobe Data Right Management, that these solutions controls how the users works with the information. You can control if he can copy or if he can print the information, but it is centered in their products. And we want to create a solution that could be used in general, not only for particular extensions or for particular documents. So that is the architecture of our solutions. We are the previous presentation is good for me, because I think that it is going to help to understand the architecture. We will have a provider. In this provider, we are going to have our information. The information there is going to be ciphered, and the user is going to access to that service provider to download the information to the mobile device. And when the user wants to download that information, he should authenticate and authorize against the identity server. So when he wants to access to a document stored in the service provider, he's going to be redirect to the identity server, and he should provide their credentials, and the identity server is going to check if the user has fulfilled the requirements to download that information. And later, we have another process. It is for download the information to the mobile device. But later, as I said, we don't want that the user has full control once the information has been downloaded. So here, we have the control to access to the information. And we are going to do that with the Java card. We are going to have the keys to access to that information, store it in the Java card. And beside, in the Java card, we are going to have a logic that allows us to check some requirements before access to that information. And it allows us, with our architecture, provide this download, that is one of the operations, and display the information. And we can provide different security policy for those operations. And the keys are not storage in the mobile device, are storage in the Java card. So if our operating system is compromised, our keys are not going to be there, are going to be in the Java card. And we are providing multi-factor authentication. The user, if you want to access to the information, you need to have the Java card and at the same time, the credentials that the users know. And the information, the operation of deciphering the information is done in the Java card that is an specific hardware for cryptographic operations, so the performance is going to be good. And we are providing multilateral and multi-level security. We have different classification levels of the information, and the users will have different security clearance. And we associate some levels to with the information, and the users need to have that levels when he wants to access to the information. And why we have chosen a WSO2 framework? Three main things have done that decision. As you can see, they have a strong authentication and authorization server, and they have a lot of functionalities created, so it is work that is done, so we can use it. And it's open source, so in the future we need some type of certification of the product. If you have access to the code, it is important. And they have a lot of documentation and very good examples when you need to deploy. And about specific aspects in the identity server, they support XHTML, as said in the presentation before. That is something that we want to use, and they have also SAML. That is something that we also want to use. So that are the main criteria that we use when we chose the solution. And the performance, as I said, it has advantage and some disadvantage that we are working on it, and I am going to tell you both. The first, the advantage, is that the in the identity server, they are using caching, so they have the XHTML evaluation is giving us a good performance, so it is good. And because of the specific hardware in the Java card, the cryptographic operation is giving a good performance. So if you want to decipher a big amount of information, we are getting better performance than if we do that in the in software or in the tablet, because it is not a specific hardware. But it has some disadvantages. The first disadvantage is the policy administration. When we speak with the people of Airbus, they told us, okay, I have a lot of documentation. You told me you are working with labels that are attached with the information, and you are and later you take some decision, and it is okay. But doing that with all the information is a problem. We are working on that, because in the future we want to create a system that allow us, based on the content, on based on some words, and based on training, that we can do that it at least a part automatically, so we can support the users. And another problem that we are having is with the Java card plus NFC connection, because of the rate of near field communication. So we want to move, and we are working right now with that, to a secure SD card that offers the same capabilities than the Java card, but they don't need the near field communication, and it doesn't have the problem of the speed rate. That is the deployment. We have the architecture before, and that is the deployment, what part of WSO2 we have used in our to create our system. And we have used for the web application the WSO2 application server and the identity server, also the WSO2. And we are using virtualization to create the system for the applications, for the service provider and for the identity provider. And they are we are using an Android mobile device, and we have created an application for Android that allows us to download the information, and later when the user wants to access, that application is connecting with the Java car and is sending the information ciphered and showing to the users the information deciphered if the user fulfills the requirements and provides the credentials. And more specific information about the version that we have used, the application server, we have used the 9.3.0 and the identity server, the 5.10. And they provide us some L, as I said, XACML, and we can have different user storage like Microsoft Active Directory. And the policy information point customization, it is a part of XACML. If you are not familiar with that, could be that you not understand, but that part allows us to create our own labels within the system. So it's something important for us too. And now I am going to show you a little demo about the download process. Later I will show you the state diagram of the Android application, but I am going to center the video in the download process. So in order to show you the functionality and the capacities of our application, I have created two profiles. One of them is Fidel. It has a security clearance of confidential. It is in the country is Spain, the institution is Army, and the mission is Alpha. And we have Javier, that the security clearance is top secret, and country is also Spain, but the institution is Navy, and the mission is Beta. And we are going to have two resources, two documents. UCAV 226, that the classification level is confidential, so both of them could access based on that criteria, but the country is Spain, so both can access. But the institution is Army and the mission is Alpha, so Javier could not access to that resource. And the other, UCAV 232, the classification level is secret, so Fidel cannot access to that document, and the country is Spain, so it only has these labels associated, so Javier can access to that. And now I am going to show you the video. As you can watch here in this first image, we have the different elements. We have the tablet, that is the part in which the user is going to download the information and to display it. We have the Java cars of Javier and Fidel, and we have the server that contains the identity server and the service provider. And we are going to watch how Fidel access to the system to download the information, and later how Javier tried to access to the system to download information also. And we are going to start with Fidel. Fidel should provide their credentials to access to the system. As you can see, the password is not very good. And now he has access to the system, and we have created it based on the, like a tree, based on the labels that we have in that example. First is the countries, then the missions, and then the institutions, and finally the missions. So if Fidel tried to access to Spain, he has the label Spain, so he can access to the information, to that directory. And As you can see, Fidel has access to Spain, and you can see here the different institutions. He cannot access to Navy, but he can access to Army, and he can access to, he cannot access to Beta, but he can access to Alpha. And he has, he can download that file because he has the labels. But he, if he try to download here the UCAF 232, it is secret and Fidel is confidential, so he cannot download that file. So he cannot access to that file because of that. And now it's the same, but if we try, if we do the same, but in that case with Javier, we are going to see how Javier can access to the directories that are related with his labels, but cannot access to the other part of the system. So if he tried to access to Army, he couldn't because he's Navy. So he's and he's Beta, he's not Alpha. So if he tried to access to Alpha, he couldn't. And he access to Beta. And finally, he can download the file. UCAP 232, because he is top secret and the file is secret. Basically, it is in a short example the part of the downloading the information. So that finish that part, and with that, Fidel has download or Javier. Has downloaded the Fidel and Javier has downloaded the information, but if they try to access to that files, they couldn't see it because it is different. So they need to use our application to access to that information. I know that we have no time, so I have shown that a state diagram of our application. So the first thing that they need to do is to put the Java car in the range of the NFC, in the NFC range, and later we will see the file associated with the with his profile. But later in the Java car is going to perform an authentication of the user and an authorization based on the labels associated with the information. When we download the information, it has associated some labels that are going to be checked within the Java car before decrypting the file. So in that step that we can see here, he is going to provide the credentials and is going to be checked the authorization for that. For that users, that in the Java car we have stored the labels associated with the users. And finally, if he can access, the application is going to show the content. If not, it is going to show an error. Basically, that is what I want to tell you about the about our